Another episode of Catamount Connection here, and we're with the director of athletics at UVM, Jeff Schulman, to talk about a lot. We have fan questions about the new head coach of the men's hockey team, Todd Woodcroft, and a handful of other things. So, Jeff, how you doing? What's going on at your house these days?
There's a lot going on in my house. There's five of us here, my wife, Deb, and my three kids, Theodore, Gabby, and Marzi, are 17, 14, and 11. So there's a lot of activity, if any of them run by while we're talking to each other. I hope you forgive me. But, you know, obviously it's a different time for all of us, you know, in the world, really. Certainly in higher education and in college athletics, to not have students on campus, to not have normal activity that we would typically see this time of year is very different for all of us. But there's plenty to do, I can assure you that.
So I know you've been in contact with our fans, our partners, and pretty much everybody over the last couple of weeks. But is there any update with the athletic department in general right now? Anything just off the top that you think people should know?
Well, it's, you know, I've been really, first of all, I'm so appreciative of the support that we've had from the community and from, you know, our alumni and the campus community and our fans. And it's just, you know, obviously our seasons came to an end in a manner which, you know, you just can't really ever imagine, just so abruptly. And obviously feel for our student athletes and our coaches and our fans, you know, right before the American East basketball championship game, right in the middle of the spring sport season, our ski team was literally in the middle of its championship out west. And you know, it's amazing, our athletes and our coaches, and I haven't heard one bit of self-pity, and, you know, their response has just been really uplifting, I guess, for me, and inspiring, I think, in so many ways. And it just reinforces, you know, the fact that we just have amazing student athletes and coaches and staff and a great community that supports us.
Are you just Zoom calling all the time with coaches and student athletes and teams and stuff, or what's your communication like?
It's my daughter, Marzi.
Hey, Marzi.
In the background.
Hi.
Marzi, I'm in the middle of an interview.
I know, I was trying to get
I'm Zoom calling. Yes, lots of Zoom calling. We use Microsoft Teams a lot on campus as well. And, you know, every other form of interactive video conferencing, I've probably used it.
That's awesome. All right, so we'll roll into these questions now about Todd Woodcroft, and really, really exciting news last week for me and for all UVM men's hockey fans and anybody with the program. We've talked to Jerry Tarrant about it. I've talked to Todd Woodcroft about it too, and some fans fired off questions for you. So we'll let Jake Orr start us off. He wants to know, it's a big picture question from Jake. What are reasonable expectations for the program over the next 5 years for men's hockey?
Well, thanks for that question, Jake. You know, I've been really clear about this, that our goal is to win a national championship in our hockey program. And I do think it's realistic. You know, if you look at some schools that have won national championships over the years, all in the last 10 years, Union and Providence and Yale, you know, the reality is there's only 60 teams that play Division I men's college hockey. We play in as good a conference as there is in the country. We've proven that we can get to the Frozen Four, and obviously once you get that far, anything can happen. So our goal is to have a championship team, and when I say that, of course, I mean not just competitively, but academically, in terms of our service to the community, in terms of the development of our student athletes, in all sorts of different ways. And I believe that's realistic. Obviously, we want to build it in a way that's sustainable. We're not looking for a quick fix. And Todd and I have had lots of conversations about this, that, you know, I want to see us rebuild the program in the right way, you know, and obviously with an emphasis on academics and integrity. And I think Todd's the right person to do that. And doesn't mean that, you know, overnight we're going to be winning a national championship. You know, I've had several conversations through the search process with David Quinn, the former Boston University coach, who's now the coach of the New York Rangers. And we talked a lot about his first year at BU. And he said he'll never forget having a conversation with his athletic director, Drew Marichello, who's a good friend of mine, and Mike Lynch, who actually, Mike was the AD at the time, Drew was the associate AD. And he remembers that they hadn't won a game in 2 months. And he just said to them, like, you know, we've got to go through this in order to get to where we need to be. And I'm not saying we're going to not win a game for 2 months next year, but it is a process. And Todd knows that, and I know that. But the ultimate goal is for UVM hockey to win a national championship.
So before we get to how Coach Woodcroft can help out with that, the facility project is obviously on a lot of people's minds, and Brock Paquette was wondering, how will the facility improvements help recruiting specifically?
Well, you know, I think people who know our program, certainly our fans, know that Gutterson Fieldhouse is an incredible college hockey venue. It's on everybody's list when they're reeling off the top college hockey locations or places to go see a game. It's really iconic, and the energy on a game night there when we have things going is really second to none. The reality is, when we're recruiting student athletes or prospective student athletes, they often will visit campus during their off times, which are often our off times. So they're not often able to see a game. So they are looking at things like locker rooms and video rooms and training rooms, academic support areas. And those spaces matter. You know, we're obviously competing against some elite programs for the best student athletes, almost all of whom have invested in facility improvements over the past several years. And again, we're not looking to build gold-plated lockers, but it is important that the facilities reflect the importance of the program. And that's our goal with the facility project. And obviously to improve the fan experience as well. You know, we've got incredible fans that have supported us through good times and challenging times. And one of the very important goals of this project is to make their experience in the Gut more comfortable and more enjoyable. So improved seating, improved concessions, restrooms, video boards, all of that. So it's going to help the fan experience, and it's also going to help us recruit top level student athletes.
In general, with COVID-19 impacting the entire world and so many different things, how is it specifically impacting the facility project on campus?
So, you know, we're in a pause in our construction activity right now as a result of Governor Scott's stay home, stay safe order that has shut down virtually every construction site in the state of Vermont. So we're paused right now. And, you know, given the level of economic uncertainty that exists everywhere in our country and really in the world, our trustees have asked us to use this time to look at all aspects of the project and try to identify where there may be some efficiencies, where we may be able to resequence in certain ways that make for a more efficient project, and also takes some of the short-term financial burden off the institution. So, you know, the good news is that all of our donors are 100% behind us and supportive. We've even had new gifts come in since the virus outbreak in support of the project, and our board and President Garamella are fully behind the project and committed to making it happen. So the timeline may be adjusted. Obviously, I don't know exactly what that will be right now. As soon as we have more information about that, we'll communicate it out to people. But you know, we're obviously really excited about all aspects of this project and excited to get moving forward again as soon as the governor's order allows.
Certainly nice to have some things to look forward to, and especially something like that. So now to kind of turn and look at Coach Woodcroft, and I know you introduced him in a video last week and talked a little bit about it, and we've put articles out and all that stuff, but a couple of questions, we'll put these two together. So the first one is from Troy Austin, who just wants to know why you chose Coach Woodcroft and what excites you about him. And then kind of off that, Kevin Lawless was wondering if Coach Woodcroft's lack of NCAA experience came into question while you're going through this process, and if so, what kind of trumped that and what decision or what helped you make the decision to overlook that and make him the head coach?
Sure. You know, those are both good questions from Troy and Kevin. And, you know, in terms of the things that excited me about Todd, you know, there's a lot of them. You know, his background in the game, his knowledge of the game is really exceptional. His reputation, and I would say an international reputation, you know, he's done a lot of work with national federations overseas in Sweden and elsewhere in Europe. His reputation for skill development and player development is outstanding. And that's a really important part of success at the college level. Obviously, you have to recruit good players but it's really important that you develop them as well. He's got a fantastic background in player development and his networks in terms of recruiting, you know, very different than I think you see from a lot of college coaches right now. His experiences throughout North America and throughout Europe are really impressive. And I think will help us in terms of opening up new recruiting avenues. So, you know, those were just a few of those things. He's also, I think he's a great fit for UVM philosophically. He's, you know, even though his experience is at the pro level, he has 2 degrees, one from McGill, one from the University of Toronto. He cares about academics. He believes in the combination of elite player development and hockey and higher education and school. So I think he's a great fit for UVM. And in relation to Kevin's question, I certainly realize that he does not fit the traditional pedigree of most college hockey coaches. And frankly, I view that as a plus. You know, one of the things that we're trying to do is distinguish our program. And we don't want to be exactly like everybody else. And that's important in terms of recruitment. And again, one of Todd's real strengths is player development and skill development. And as our fans know, the players who are coming to play college hockey at an elite level and that are real difference makers are players who want to play beyond college hockey. And one of the things that they're really looking for is the ability to develop their game so that they can turn professionally, hopefully at the NHL level or at another level of professional hockey. And Todd certainly has the background in the professional game to help players do that. Is there going to be a learning curve on certain things related to the NCAA? Of course, you know, recruiting rules and just sort of the rhythm of the recruiting calendar and season. But honestly, that's the easy stuff. And that's certainly something that, you know, that I can help Todd with, just, you know, given my background in understanding the landscape of college hockey. And Joe Gervais, our associate athletic director, who was a college hockey coach and also played hockey at Vermont when he was a student. So we can help support him in that. He's obviously going to hire a staff of people who have NCAA experience. So I think I'm really excited about Todd. I think he's going to be a breath of fresh air for our players, for our community, and I think for college hockey as a whole.
So I know a lot of people are excited about the opportunity to recruit new players. And Richard Kuhn was wondering, how do we as a university create an environment that draws those higher caliber student athletes on a consistent basis? And how will Coach Woodcroft be a part of that?
Well, he's obviously going to be a big part of it. And, you know, I'll start with something that I said in the previous answer, which is his reputation for player development and skill development is exceptional. And so I think that when players are evaluating their options, and again, with an eye on wanting to play hockey post-college, they're going to be looking for a program where they can really develop their game. And this is going to be one of those. And I think that will benefit us from a recruiting standpoint. And again, you know, I think student athletes are looking for, you know, that right combination of academics and athletics and a community that really supports and values what they do. And our community certainly does that. You know, our fans are second to none. The energy at the gut, as we talked about before, is exceptional. And so to be able to go to a program where you can get an amazing education, you can develop as a player and become a professional if that's the direction you want to go, or move on to a career in whatever it is you choose to do, and do it in an amazing community like Burlington, surrounded by incredible fans, that's a pretty powerful recruiting pitch. And I know that's what Todd's going to lean on, and it's part of the reason that I'm so excited about the future of our program.
So Thomas Chittenden asked a really cool question, kind of as in respect to the entire university. He asked, how do you see student retention efforts aligned with or tied to the performance and facilities of UVM's most notable athletic programs?
That's a good question. And, you know, I'll try to interpret that a little bit. I think he's, you know, maybe he's talking a little bit about student athletes, but I think he's probably also talking about general student recruitment and retention at the university. And I think there's a lot of ways athletics and recreation and wellness on our campus help in that regard. One is, you know, from a varsity athletics standpoint, I think the energy and the excitement and the passion around our teams is kind of unique on our campus. There's very few opportunities where hundreds and hundreds, sometimes thousands of students come together in one place cheering on the green and gold, next to community members, next to faculty members, next to staff members, next to alumni. And that happens, you know, multiple times a week, as you know, Michael, in our facilities at Gutterson, at Patrick, Virtue Field. And so, you know, that kind of energy and campus excitement and morale is a really positive thing. And I think helps our students to have a positive experience and ultimately helps in recruiting new students, not just student athletes, but general students, the general student body, and helps retain them because they're having a positive, enjoyable, fun experience on campus on top of obviously their academic priorities. And in terms of this facility project, as people who have followed it know very well, this is not only a varsity athletic project. There's major improvements to Gutterson, construction of the new Tarrant Center for men's, women's basketball and campus events and community events. And then a major facility improvement for recreation and wellness, the Fitty Davis Recreation and Wellness Center, that is going to dramatically enhance student recreation and wellness and health. And UVM has always been the kind of campus that draws students who care about health and well-being and being physically active and fit. And it's now, you know, when this project is complete, we're going to have facilities that align with that passion from our students. And so it will help recruit students to the campus. It will help retain the students that we have. It will help with our faculty and with our staff in terms of their wellness and hopefully their overall health and well-being and enjoyment of their job. So all along, this project has been designed to touch a lot of different areas. And I think once it's complete, people will recognize that and really appreciate the approach.
Definitely nice to have some things to look forward to, especially with, you know, a lot going on right now. So it's cool to have some excitement, especially around UVM. Is there anything else you want to get in before we let you go and get back to either the kids or your next Zoom call?
Or some combination of the two.
Yeah, or both.
No, obviously I just want to wish everybody well. And, I sent out a communication to our fans and the campus community earlier last week. And one of the things that I highlighted in that was the loss of three really special people in the UVM athletics community. Mama Gooch, Marianne Gucciardi, who was, you know, as big a fan as UVM athletics has ever had, you know, dating well back before I was a student athlete here, but generations of athletes, have memories of her and her spaghetti dinners and just the warmth and graciousness and passion that she had for UVM athletics and especially for our student athletes was unmatched. And Tony Adams, of course, who was a legend for I don't even know how many years at Channel 3, but was always, you know, an amazing figure in the state of Vermont and cared deeply about UVM athletics and always treated us well and had great friendships, you know, with every athletic director, probably dating back to Ed Donnelly and certainly Denny Lambert, and Rick Farnham and Bob Horn and me. And then Bernie Jeskowitz, who was a member of our board of trustees and a great advocate and passionate fan of UVM athletics, passed away a couple of weeks ago as well. So, and these weren't all COVID related. I think Bernie did die of COVID related causes, but that's obviously weighed heavily on all of our minds. And in addition to just, you know, caring about our fans and our student athletes and our staff, obviously, and the community that supports us. So it's we live in a really special place and have amazing alumni all over the world. And I just want to send my best out to all of them and thank them for their amazing support.
All right, Jeff. Well, thanks for doing an episode of Catamount Connection. I'm sure we'll get you on again soon when we have more updates or anything else changes, as everything seems to change so fast. So thanks for doing this.
Thank you, Michael.